Fantasy warfare, they called it. Fantasy warfare. The match that they wanted to see once again, which didn't turn out that well last time at WrestleMania. And they had the rematch, which lasted less than 90 seconds. Holy crap. How's it going, guys? Mr. Gaming Fam here, and welcome to another episode of Sports Talk. I know you can say wrestling is not a sport, but I don't care. I like WWE. I guess you find that out already. And of course, I saw Survivor Series. And I, of course, like I just said, I saw the Bill Goldberg-Brock Lesnar rematch. Their first match, their rematch in 12 years, I believe, in one of the previous WrestleManias. And it was held as one of the worst, not even WrestleMania matches, but one of the worst matches of all time in wrestling. And they had their rematch last night at Survivor Series in Toronto, Canada. And it was something. It was something. So I just want to quickly go through all my thoughts on the other matches. Just quickly go through, in my opinion. So, and then we'll talk about in depth more about the main event. So I'm not going to talk about some of the pre-match show. The pre-matches like the six-man tag and the Kane versus Luke Harper, because no one gives a crap. So let's talk about the first 5-on-5 Survivor Series elimination match. It was the women's match. It was Team Raw, which was Sasha Banks, Bayley, Alicia Fox, and Nia Jax, with Dana Brooke, against SmackDown, which was that Natalya, who replaced Nikki Bella, Carmella, Alexa Bliss, Naomi, and Becky Lynch. And the Raw one, I liked it. It was good, and it made, obviously, Bayley got the pin. We made her look strong. She got her nice little moment in one of those big four pay-per-views. And Charlotte attacked Bayley after the match, which hopefully could set up possibly a feud, which hopefully that could develop Bayley's character further on the line. We could see that possibly at Roadblock, which is the next WWE next Raw pay-per-view. Next match was the Intercontinental Championship, The Miz with Maurice against Sami Zayn. The Miz recently won it on SmackDown. He beat Dolph Ziggler, which in my opinion, my interest was a little less in my opinion, because I would love to see both Ziggler and against Zayn, because those guys are over. They have a lot of fan support, and but it was fine. It was definitely fine. I understand The Miz, obviously he just won, so I don't want them to flip flop the belts, because that would be, it wouldn't value the belt a whole lot. Maurice, she's a great heel manager, and The Miz is one of the best heels. He's probably the best true heel on the roster, because yeah, you say Kevin Owens is a heel and Chris Jericho is a heel. They get huge pops, not only because they were in Canada, they're just amazing. They're great on the mic, and they're just good. They're really good. So overall, that was fine. Next up was the 10-on-10 tag team elimination match with Team Raw, which featured The New Day, Sheamus and Cesaro, Enzo and Bay Cast, The Shining Stars, The Club, the New Day. New Day was represented by Big E and Kofi Kingston, against Team SmackDown Live, Heath Slater and Rhino, The Hype Bros, American Alpha, and Breezango and the Usos. And Raw won. I guess that was fine, but well, let's talk about some of the things I liked. There are some good things. You know, it was fun, it was enjoyable. Overall in this pay-per-view, I liked the wrestling. I thought the wrestling itself was really good. I really liked the wrestling, like I said. There were some good spots. The New Day eliminated early. That was a little bit of a shock, honestly, because obviously they're the champions and all that. But it was fine, because it had other people to spotlight and see possibly who the next number one contender for the Raw tag teams. The Club looked great. Enzo Cass looked good. American Alpha looked good. Heath Slater and Rhino looked good. Sheamus and Cesaro looked great. And yeah, and they pinned the Usos, who were also good. All of them were great, I guess you could say, except for the New Day and Breezango. And Cesaro is amazing. Sheamus is good. I like Sheamus. And they got they won. They won the match for Team Raw. And then at the end of the match, Cesaro put his hand out for Sheamus to be like, "Hey, you know, let's be a tag team. You know, let's get on the same page." And then Sheamus, no handshake. And they do when Sheamus raises his hand in the air, everyone boos, and Cesaro does it. And I was just like, "Really? You're gonna throw this away?" So nothing changes. Mick Foley, come on Mick. So actually they took those two matches. So they won. They pretty much won. Okay. So I would rather seen SmackDown win this match, and then we have a cool decider on who I think was gonna win the other 5-on-5 elimination match. So next up was the Cruiserweight Championship. It was Brian Kendrick versus Kalisto. And if Kalisto won, not only he gets the belt, but the whole Cruiserweight division is transferred to SmackDown. And I thought they both looked great. I thought Kalisto looked really good. I thought Brian Kendrick looked good. And why did they bother including Baron Corbin? Okay, so you're going to say that Baron Corbin is not healthy to fight in the 5-on-5 elimination match, but he's healthy enough to jump over a barricade, get in the ring, and do his finisher on Kalisto. Okay, and walk it off. Yeah, you know, that's totally fine. That's reasonable. Yeah, why? Why? And his reason. Well, it was terrible. He tried to explain it in the backstage segment with Daniel Bryan. It made no sense. It was other bullcrap. That was probably the only really down moment, because it also doesn't make sense with 205 Live also on Tuesdays, and that would have been a lot easier because they also have the show on Tuesday and also SmackDown Tuesday. And also, I think SmackDown would do a lot better, especially with Daniel Bryan and Mauro Ranallo, who were both the commentators for the Cruiserweight Classic. That made a lot more sense. I also think the writing is a lot better in SmackDown than Raw, because it doesn't have to like drag out moments. So that was that. I didn't like that. I didn't like that at all. So the 5-on-5 traditional match, which was Team SmackDown, which consisted of AJ Styles, Dean Ambrose, Randy Orton, Shane McMahon, and Bray Wyatt. James Ellsworth was the mascot, and then later Luke Harper was involved against Team Raw, which featured Kevin Owens, Chris Jericho, Roman Reigns, Seth Rollins, and Braun Strowman. This was my favorite match. This was match of the night. I really enjoyed this match. This was a lot of fun. A lot of fun. There was a lot of good storylines. For one, Ellsworth costing Braun Strowman. That was great. I really liked it. Ellsworth hold on to his legs, and then right after, he is thrown through a table, and I was like, holy crap, that is the greatest thing ever. That was awesome. I loved it. I was laughing my ass off. It made my day. Also, there was a lot of good things. It was just a lot of fun, I thought. And holy crap, did you hear the reception of both Jericho, especially Jericho. Oh my god, he got a huge pop. And Kevin Owens, and oh my god, every time Roman Reigns was in the ring, he was booed. Booed out of the arena. There was I didn't hear a single person cheer. It was all boos. And there was a lot of great moments. The mini Shield reunion. Look, I would have understood at the very, very end, because if they wanted Raw to do a clean sweep, and they could have had Ambrose still in the match, Ambrose then could have turned on AJ Styles, and then he would have gave himself up possibly, and then gave Raw the win. I think that would be a lot better. But hey, they had their little moment. They had their little moment, their little Shield reunion, which was actually pretty cool. It was pretty cool. I'd like to see how that develops in the future. And also, I need to talk about Shane McMahon. Hopefully he's okay. He did a coast to coast. And then Roman Reigns hit him with a spear, and he was knocked out. He was in another place. He didn't look okay. He also kicked out of his pin, but they was like, no, he can't continue. Yeah, I think that was a good decision just to get rid of him in the match. He did not look okay. And also his elbow, he on the top rope through the announce table. That was amazing. That was awesome. But hopefully Shane McMahon's okay. He did not look good after that. That's not Roman Reigns' fault. It was just a bad timing. So, and also Randy Orton taking the spear and then Bray Wyatt hitting with his sister Abigail. Hopefully Randy Orton is a true Wyatt family. Hopefully he's not like doing this for like, hey, I'm just showing you that you are weak. Hopefully not. But overall, I really enjoyed the match. And also, it was almost an hour. It was 52 minutes and 55 seconds. I'm looking on Wikipedia. That's how long the match was. That's awesome. Now, the main event. The talking point. Everyone was talking about this. Maybe not really, but a lot of people were talking about this on Twitter. Bill Goldberg versus Brock Lesnar. Their rematch after 12 years. That was the last time Bill Goldberg stepped into a wrestling ring with in a competitive competition. And what happened? Bill Goldberg defeated. No, he did not defeat. He squashed Brock Lesnar in a minute and 24 seconds. I was, in all the years I've been watching wrestling, I've never been this shocked in my life. Because I did not watch WrestleMania 30 when Brock Lesnar defeated The Undertaker streak. I got back into wrestling last year. Like over the summer of last year, 2015, I got back into it. So I took I didn't watch wrestling for like 2 years. Then I got back into it. And I've never been this shocked. It was crazy. And Bill Goldberg won. I can't believe Brock Lesnar was like, he actually got Goldberg over. And especially in this time. And probably people are wondering, well, why was it this short? I think for two reasons. One, there was a report that Bill Goldberg kind of tweaked his shoulder on the last Raw when he was throwing out the security card, so he didn't feel all that great. Second, they probably knew about last WrestleMania and how poorly received it was. So like, okay, so let's not drag this match and make it short and quick. I thought maybe like 5 minutes quick, but holy crap, I didn't think a minute and 24 seconds. And honestly, although I was shocked and I was kind of disappointed at first, I think this was probably the best decision they could have made. For one, it makes Bill Goldberg still relatively strong, but it also makes Brock Lesnar a little more down to earth. He's human. He's human. He's not a beast that we know he is, but he's still brought down to earth and he's still a human. And yeah, Brock Lesnar can be defeated, which hopefully that can have a nice character change, a whole switch in Brock Lesnar's character. And I also want to see Goldberg on Raw, and I've heard that he looks like he could have a contract that goes to the Royal Rumble, which would be awesome. I would love to see Goldberg because he is over. He is really over. He's one of the top baby faces, even despite his really, really recent return. I think this was a great match. Not a great match. He went with two spears and a jackhammer. And I was like, oh my god. I was never this shocked. I was like, holy crap. I couldn't believe it. And I think this was the best decision because it's completely different. It got people talking. It makes people want to see what happens next on Raw, which I haven't been this excited probably since when Seth Rollins came back, returned at Extreme Rules. I've never been this excited. Wow. So overall, Survivor Series wasn't that bad. It was a pretty good match. I thought it was a lot better than WrestleMania, a lot better than SummerSlam, and probably better than the Royal Rumble. I can't believe it. Wow. That happened. So guys, what are your thoughts on the Survivor Series? And man, I've never been this excited for Raw in a while. Although I said it was when Seth Rollins returned. But man, wow. So yeah, guys, what are your thoughts on Survivor Series and what do you think they're gonna do with Bill Goldberg and Brock Lesnar? And that's it, guys. Thank you guys for watching. Comment, rate, and subscribe for more content on this channel. Follow me on Twitter at Mr. Game of Fame. And I'll see you guys next time.